branding. So with branding, this is a question you have to ask yourself. This is something that you got to ask yourself. So when people are coming to you and asking for help, they know exactly what they're coming for. I'll give you an example. So, and then I gave you a couple of examples, but I'll give you one specific. So there's, one reason why I choose not to promote multiple network marketing companies is because I want to be the guy that has, the jacket. Like, hey, I got these watches, these wrists, and these necklaces, but if they go here, I got earrings and bracelets and all, because you're just trying to sell and trying to make money. I don't want to be known for that. So I want to be known as a person who is, I want to be known as, I would say, network marketing. I'm a network marketing professional. I want to be known for a person who, helps people get leads, sales, traffic, learn how to recruit people in their business. So I want to be known for that online. So when people are coming to my website, they know that, whether they see the testimonials or they see my content, that's what they know what they're coming to get. Now the people who are against network marketing, they go away. The people who might accidentally not on my page, they go away. So it's rejection free. But the people who are actually, and we talk about this a little bit with the content and the SEO stuff, but since I've targeted network marketers and people who work from home through my content, the majority of my people who come through my website are people that I'm attracting. It's my avatar. It's my avatar. So, so people, come to my blog and even they search my name or they search my videos, they see my videos, it's going to be all, value-based about network marketing. So the question is, what do you want to be known for when you're out there online? Now, say for example, because I'm affiliate of a few things, but say that I want to be an affiliate of Turtle Soup or something like that. So I want to not put that on my office blog or anything like that. I would have another website or somewhere else where I'm actually targeting, people who are, interested in organic turtle soup or something like that. So it would be congruent with my brand. But say that that's why on my blog and my website, I have affiliates like MLSP. I have affiliates like Elite Marketing Pro because these are
aligned.
Yeah, they're aligned with my brand. These are companies that if they click on it, obviously I make money. But they're also, these are companies that are, industry-based, home-based industry-based, where they provide value to the home-based business industry as well. So, people who are struggling with recruiting or struggling with what questions to ask, then, I can create a blog post about that and then lead them to one of those affiliate links. And also, I can do the same thing. Like, say, for example, I wanted to, I could talk about all business opportunity. I could talk about my business opportunity on there. Because the thing is, like with most people who are in network marketing, they're all company based. They only talk about everything in their company, which is fine. If you want to be focused on your company, that's great. More power to you. Scream from the sky. Promote it. Like you love it. Because if you don't promote like you love it, then who will? Right. So, but me personally, I just don't want to help people in my company. I want to help more people. I want to impact a lot more people. I think that, in my opinion, I think you limit yourself when, now if you you got success in your company and stuff like that, you got that celebrity status we were talking about, then yes, you know, I mean, you can, you know, help your downline, your sideline, your cross line, your upline, if your upline wants to listen. But you can help those people if you want to inside your company. Now, me personally, like I want to be an impact on my whole industry. So that's why I brand myself as impacting the whole industry, not just my company, but the whole industry. So with that being said, when you guys are branding yourself, make sure that you know what do you want to be known for. So when somebody's coming to you and they're asking questions, you know, even if you don't have it, obviously you get your upline. But when they're asking questions to you, then they know exactly what they're getting. They know that product or service that they're getting. Does that make sense? So this is my website right here. So, and I'm gonna give you some of the industry leaders too. So I'm gonna just be clear. So this right here is my office right here. This one right here, they are 6 figures online. Follow this five-step formula. So when I click this, it goes straight to a capture page. So this right here, it's a video, it's a capture page. And to get this right here, it's basically saying simple top earner secrets to get more leads, customers, and reps, make more money in your home business, 10 days. So if somebody's in a home-based business, they're gonna see this. And even if they try to play this, if they try to play it, it's like, wait, put your name and your information in, right? So they get access, they put their name and their information in. When they put their name and their information in, it goes to my CRM, my autoresponder, and then they get sent an email. But now I have their email and I have their name, so I can market to them. Now they're on my list. This is the goal when you're online. You want to build your list. You want to build a list of potential clients and customers. All right? I won't go through the formula. I want to give you examples of objects. So here's another guy. I think everybody knows this guy. Maybe they don't.
Hi.
Follow him.
I'm Ray Hagan, and I show network marketing.
So this guy, Ray Hagan, he's one of my mentors. I've been following him now for about 4 or 5 years, something like that. But this is how his blog looks like. So he has an option right here. You know, 29 sources to get leads now. It's a download MP3. So if I wanted that opt-in, if I wanted that MP3, I'll put my name, my email, I'll be on his list, which I actually am, and then I'll get that download. Alright, so these are opt-ins that, I'm just trying to give you guys ideas. This right here, and you know this guy, Network Marketing Pro, Eric Ward. Same thing. So he's actually giving away his free training, he's giving away his book right here. Get the free training and GoPro book for free. Just so he's giving away something, change for the name and the email. Alright? So these are ideas. And the thing is, you can change these anytime you want to. It's not set in stone. So say for example, you have a good opt-in, or say you have an opt-in and it's not converting like you want it to, you can change it. How simple to change that when you're speaking with your prospects, asking you guys questions, it's like, oh, I need this, I'm struggling with this, or this one having trouble with it. But basically, don't always think as a consumer when you're speaking to your prospects. Think as an entrepreneur, because if these guys, once you start asking questions, they start opening up to you guys, what's going to end up happening is that you're going to start getting bad information, and then you can start writing this stuff down. Write it down, put it in your phone, whatever, and then you can go turn it to an MP3. Park your car, like, hey, here's 10 things you need to know as an entrepreneur. If you're trying to be an employee, transition from an employee to an entrepreneur. That's a great opt-in for somebody, looking for a business opportunity. So you just tell, just tell them that you just suggested 10 things. But these are opt-in forms. Now, bad opt-in, so bad opt-in forms. So let me show you the right below now, because I didn't really. These are terrible ideas, and you've probably seen these. I see these all the time. And I'm pretty sure you guys have not put your information in this. So, people will have on the website, join me today. subscribe now. Subscribe now. You know, unless you have like a huge brand, and I don't even think that even he does that. But if you have like a huge brand name like Tony Robbins or something like that, like these are not gonna work. Like people, you gotta give something of substance of why people are gonna want to receive emails from you. Okay? So if you are not, I mean, and there's a couple of more of them, I can't think of any right now off the top of my head. But these are like the main ones I see all the time where people are just joining me, you know, because they're just trying to get your email list, get on their email list. And it's like, join me today, subscribe now, you know, free gift for me, but you don't know what the free gift is. You know, free gift. All right, what gift am I getting? You know? Yeah, I have no idea what gift I'm getting, but you want me to subscribe to your, you know, get on your list. So, be creative. Be creative when you create an opt-in. You know, give something away. How can I say this? So when you want to, the time that you're putting into creating an opt-in, you know, it has to be valuable. Meaning that, you know, say for example, you create an opt-in. You know, so say for example, you know how to do an ebook. Like, hey, this is how you create an ebook for your network marketing company. That could be an option. I mean, there's, you know, I could come up with these all day. So you have an ebook, and then you teach them how to create an ebook, for the network marketing company. So you're shaping that. But on the back end, and this is a little bit more advanced, so we won't get into it today. But on the back end, you could be selling, you know, something, you know, like I'm selling on something, you know, like a $20 product or something like that. You know, but you don't need enough.